Okay, it's Friday, September 22nd, I believe, or 22nd or 23rd, whatever, Friday, September. I got one of my knobs, this right here. Let me show people something here. See this right here? Okay. Now you see all this? See how long it's taking me to do that, to get that off? I don't keep these knobs just on like that. They've always been up to the brace, at least, if not a little bit tighter. Miraculously, this one just fell off. It unscrewed itself and it fell off. So it's out here in the yard somewhere. And I got all these leaves around here too. I raked up some yesterday, or day before yesterday, going over it. And I mean, I don't know how else I'm gonna find it. But, you know, it unthreaded itself quite a bit and fell off. But I'm gonna show you this. All right, focus. It's a great camera, it is from Sony, so there's your quality right there. It kind of looks like foam is what it looks like on here. And it's on this rosemary plant. It's also on the pecan tree over there. I was looking at it yesterday to see if that was diseased. Like the back one's got spots all over it, which means it's diseased. As are these three plants up here and perhaps that one up there in the front too. They have a spot. They've had it on there for 2 or 3 years and now it's just going to get worse. So it does affect the garden. People don't realize that. The leaves do get in the garden, as you can see. I don't have anything protecting these things like some people might. Don't have the means to do so. I do have plastic to help encourage heat on the soil to make the growth quicker and go longer. But later today or tomorrow, this, from this garden all the way to the end over there, that garden and this little middle piece here where we had garlic last year is going to be tilled up. I mean tilled up. And might do it again, I don't know, within the next 2 to 3 weeks, till it again. And when these stop dying, when these start this is basil. This, we didn't realize how big this was and how it would take off. This got so big. Look at that. Look how it's just infiltrated with all the tomatoes. And the tomatoes are all late starter. Got the worms off primarily, about 95% of them. Once in a while we catch one. But you can see there's still tomatoes growing on there. We try to keep them up off the plastic because, you know, then they get bad spots on them and whatnot. But look at that tomato right there. You can see the spots on that one. So I'll make that a bad tomato here shortly. I probably threw it out today. Remember, it's a Sony. Look how quality this is. This is on the, I got this on the easy setting where it's supposed to like autofocus pretty much by itself. I can hold it here for 2 or 3 minutes. And I know I'm not that steady, but it should focus a little bit. But I can just take it right up here and put the camera right up to the damn tomato because the stupid ass autofocus isn't working like it should. What do you want for a $300 camera? Jesus Christ. You would think a $300 camera would be well enough that would pretty much do most of what it says it should do. Autofocus my ass. But, yeah, that's the garden out here now. And whatever that white stuff is, these are flowers on this basil. Whatever the white stuff is on the rosemary, is on the pecan tree over there. I'm cutting down the few sunflowers that were out here in the garden, using the stalks for fireplace starter. Where I'm standing, this will be off of garlic and maybe some onion even. And then this will be the number two garden. We're going to put plastic on it next spring in February. February is when we're going to start planting out here, the third week of February. We're going to till it around the third week of February, and then the last week of February is when we'll put out seed and whatnot. See, you know, that's a purple hull bee. And it looks like